right, take a look, a good look at this slide right here. We have a lot of information on quadrilaterals. So, first of all, notice this diagram up here. A quadrilateral is split up into three categories. It can either be a trapezoid, a parallelogram, or a trapezium. So let's think about what is the difference here. Well, a trapezium has no parallel sides. Notice this trapezium here. None of these sides are parallel. Okay, so a trapezium has no parallel sides. A trapezoid has one pair of parallel sides. A trapezoid, exactly one pair of parallel sides, and it's the opposite ones, clearly. And a parallelogram, both sets of sides are parallel. So, first of all, we're splitting them up into three different categories. No pairs of parallel sides, one pair of parallel sides, or both pairs of sides are parallel. Then, for trapeziums, we do have a special kind of trapezium, which is a kite, and exactly two pairs of consecutive sides are congruent. Notice in this kite right here that those two sides are congruent and those two sides are congruent. So it's the consecutive sides that are congruent. With trapezium, we have the kites. With trapezoids, we do have a special kind of trapezoid, which we'll talk about at some point, called a isosceles trapezoid, but it's not on here. But for parallelograms, this is where we can get really specific. First of all, rectangles. A rectangle is a parallelogram where every angle is a right angle. Okay, so we still have opposite sides are parallel, but we also know that all the angles are right angles. With a rhombus, well, still opposite sides are parallel, but what's special about a rhombus is all four sides are the same length. And a square, notice how these lines come together. A square, opposite sides are parallel. The angles are all right angles, and every single side is the same length. So everything is true about a square. All these facts are the facts of a parallelogram, the facts of a rectangle, and the facts of a rhombus coming together to make up a square. So, big slide. You can always pause this or go back and copy some of these down. This is important stuff here. We want to classify each quadrilateral. We want to give multiple names if possible. So, first of all, it is a quadrilateral because there are four sides. All of these are going to be quadrilaterals, so across the board, all of these are quadrilaterals because all of these have four sides. Okay, but let's get more specific than that. Well, this one, the opposite sides are parallel, so guess what? This is also a parallelogram. See how I did that? Parallelogram, nice. But we aren't told anything about the angles or the sides, so I can't get any more specific than that. Let's take a look here. We aren't given any information about parallel sides, so this is not a parallelogram. It's not a trapezoid either. This is a trapezium. And remember, we do have that one specific case of a trapezium, the kite, where consecutive sides are congruent, and look at that. We do have consecutive sides that are congruent. So this is also a kite. Right here, well, we have one pair of parallel sides, so this is a trapezoid. We don't have any other specific cases of trapezoid that we're looking for. Right here, we have four angles that are all right angles. And if we have four angles that are all right angles, then this is going to be a rectangle. And we know all rectangles are also parallelograms. So this, here, just so we know what we're looking at. And then finally here, opposite sides are parallel, so this is a parallelogram. All sides are the same length, so this is a rhombus. But we aren't told anything about the angles, and so we don't know if it's a rectangle. We don't know if it's a square either. So here, we want to sketch each quadrilateral based on its description. In quadrilateral ABCD, each side measures 3 feet. So we know each side measures 3 feet, so we want to make sure that we are drawing these sides so they look like they could all be the same length. We're going to label it ABCD. Notice how I started with a vertex, named it A, and then when I named the other letters, and I started in one direction, I need to keep going in that direction. So A, B, C, D. I didn't go A, B, C, D, but I stayed in that direction. I went clockwise around that. Each side also measures 3 feet, so I'm going to make sure that I'm going to label one 3 feet. I could write 3 feet on all of them, but I'm going to use those tick marks to show they're all the same, and if one is 3 feet, they all must be 3 feet. On B, in quadrilateral WXYZ, each angle measures 90 degrees. So we have WXYZ, and we know that every angle is 90 degrees, so we use our right angle symbol. C, in quadrilateral RSTU, segment ST is parallel to RU, so here we go RSTU, and we know that ST is parallel to RU. So we use those marks, our parallel marks there. In quadrilateral PQRS, PQ is parallel to RS, PS is parallel to QR. Also, PQ is approximately twice as long as QR. All right. All right, so I've drawn this so that one side looks like it could be twice as long as the other side. I've got PQRS. We want PQ to be approximately twice as long as QR. This does look like it's about twice as long as this one, so that's good. We know that PQ is parallel to RS. We know that PS is parallel to QR. So I believe we have sketched that quadrilateral. All right, we want to determine the perimeter and area of this rectangle. Well, we know perimeter of a rectangle is 2 of the length plus 2 of the width. So this is 2 of our 2 centimeters plus 2 of our 3.5 centimeters. So this is 4 centimeters plus 7 centimeters, which comes out to be 11 centimeters. That is our perimeter. We also want to find the area. We know area of a rectangle is length times width, or base times height, 3.5 centimeters. So our area, 3.5 centimeters times 2 centimeters. And 3.5 times 2 is 7 centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared. On B, we want to determine the perimeter and area of the square. Well, a square, all the sides are congruent. So the perimeter is going to be 4 times that side length of 5.5 inches. The area is going to be one of those sides, 5.5 inches squared, because the base and the height are going to be the same length. Well, 4 times 5.5 should give us 22, so that's 22 inches. And then we have 5.5 squared. This is 30.25 inches squared is our units. So here we get some information. Each side of a baseball diamond measures 30 yards. Each of its corners is a right angle. So we have a baseball diamond. We which is really a square, right? If all the sides measure 30 yards and every corner is a right angle, well, this is a square, but we've kind of just rotated it so it looks more diamond-like. What kind of quadrilateral is a baseball diamond? It is a square. Give as many different names for it as possible. Oh, well, if it's a square, it's also a rectangle. It's also a rhombus. It's also a parallelogram. And very broad, yes, it is a quadrilateral. What distance must a batter run for a home run? Well, all the way around the bases, 30 times 4, which gives us 120 yards.